You ask me what makes a holy man. You have to look within. He's a man who defeats all sin. He does no wrong, he harms no one.
Oh, I learn now. You put this one.
The road to love is the holy man.
I want to delete if you give for me. If you give for me, I can't.
There's no temptation
them.
In love
so
he trusts. Expels deadly sins.
Yeah, very good.
His every step is full of love. His heart for peace
bigger,
teaches the ugly within.
Yeah. Okay. So I come on time.
The chosen one is the holy man.
I come down and I bless him for them.
Yeah, bless him.
Okay, and I delete them.
He will good never. Fly to the moon, explore the oceans deep.
How lucky I come on.
He lives on earth with the love in his hands and the soles of his feet. If you look within,
here we don't know what it is. Oh, so good.
You find the holy man.
You see how good, because I'm here, that's why the fig is released. Yeah, I'm here, that's why the fig released around. To the sea now. You see how you look at you in my room now. See that? Yeah, he listened to me for sure. You see he talking now? You see the mole? You see the mole he talking? Yeah, you see that you be by your eyewitness.
She's talking to the dog and she talks to you.
Yes.
The holy man is not highly schooled, but never lived by the sword. Destroy desires and ignorance, and keep the five moral precepts alive. He's the holy man.
Okay.
You waken up, huh?
Humans are monkeys in their restless minds, and do not die at all. Rebirth their fate, their loved ones more. If only comes when your mind is still.
So good, yeah. So
the road to love is with the holy man.
See, they come to there and they join with them. Now, some of them join together now. So
only the wise will die and rest in peace. Protect and save this world.
So much good.
Drown the voices of despair and breathe new life into this forsaken world. To find the holy man, you've got to look within.
Our special guest here, his name is Bhikkhu, which means monk. Buddha, you all know that the Buddha is an enlightened man. He was the son of a king in India. He let go of the whole idea of being wealthy and powerful to become, to work. Because he was enlightened, a lot of people followed him, and his teachings are still very strong and around today. And Dhatu is Bhikkhu's final name. Bhikkha, Buddha, Buddha, Ratu, Dhatu, Dhatu. Okay, so now the extraordinary thing is that also, in fact, Bhikkhu has a lineage of royalty in his family. He's actually the great-great-grandson of a king of Vietnam. But also, too, his family let go of all of the trappings of royalty in order to be safe and live another life, a safer life in a country where there was a lot of trouble. And you probably are going to be learning about Vietnam And some of you know about the Vietnam War, and that's why I thought it'd be a lovely opportunity for you to allow Bhikkhu to tell you his story. And I won't take up too much time. I just want to introduce his story a little bit to you. So when Bhikkhu is actually my age, and I'm not telling you how old that boy is, but when he was a little boy, the Vietnam War was on. And he was, he saw a lot of traumatic and horrible experiences in his youth. He also experienced being bombed with napalm. Now, that's just not an ordinary bomb. It's a bomb that has flammable petroleum product in it. And it was designed to get rid of the vegetation so that the countryside would be exposed. And so Bhikkhu has over 70% of his body bad third and fourth degree burns. He spent years and years in hospital. But it wasn't easy to get to hospital. His whole village had been destroyed in that bombing. And it took him days for his aunts and uncles to get him to a hospital. And even after that, it took him years of struggle and years of perseverance. And sometimes he just wanted to die. But the extraordinary thing is that out of this dreadful trauma and hardship, that Bhikkhu has decided that he would, because he was in this special situation, he'd overcome so much and he'd come across the Buddhist teachings that he was in a position to spread the word of how you can have wisdom and compassion in your life and work for peace. So that's Bhikkhu's main aim now. He's travelled the world. He's walked 9,000 kilometres with bare feet to spread the message of peace in the world. And as I offered Bhikkhu dinner the other night, he said, "No, I've already eaten. I've eaten my meal for the day, one meal." I said, "Let's go swimming." I said, "Do you want to borrow a pair of swimming costumes?" He said, "No, I've got three robes and a wooden bowl." That's all that Bhikkhu possesses. Three robes and a wooden bowl, barefoot, even in the snow in Canada. So his extraordinary story of overcoming the most difficult situation. Some of us think we've got difficulties, itchy feet or something, okay? But compared to other people's sufferings, perhaps we are the most lucky people in the world here in Australia, in the Bega Valley. I'm going to pass over and thank you very much to Bhikkhu. Give him a round of applause and welcome. Thank you. You will have to listen carefully because he's speaking with a Vietnamese accent, and I'm sure he won't mind if you put up your hand and ask him to repeat something, because I do all the time as well. Thanks, Bhikkhu.
Thank you, the principal and all the high school teacher to allow Bhikkhu to meet on our brother sitter, boy and girl. Special, she gave me 2 days rest in her kingdom, very peaceful kingdom. Then today we come to the school here, the class here. We have many class. First day when I come to her home, wonderful, I see she got a class to teach Zogi. Unbelievable. We need that experience to not only for the body, but our mind too. She teach, let go. Then today I come here with the class for education. So you go to primary already 5 years, now another 7 years for high school. And we wish one day you'll be in the university, but today the lecture Bhikkhu give for you is universal, not university. Sometimes I give a lecture, 450 university professor or 4 or 5 director, but I told them the knowledge of the worldly life we cannot carry along with us. But we have to learn the universal teaching. Our Buddha, our messenger Jesus, 2,000 years and 2,600 years. So brother and sister, boy and girl, we are one. I write the song, if you enjoy that. We are one, you are me. I am you. When you born, same I born. When I suffer, what she introduced about the war, and you read my book, you not die yet, right? You're not die yet, so you now don't know what is death. But I say it this way, I return from death. 5.5 days, I left my body in the best hospital in Thailand. After I arrived from India, because I spent 10 years in a poor country. There, our brother, sister, our children very suffer, not like lucky you are here. Wonderful country, the best country in the world, in our country. I traveled in 45 countries, and I come and land only Singapore 131 times. And you see that, but I'm not land to your heart yet. So I have to land to your heart, to touch your heart, at the way for our mission. Many religions, they lock the door to convert each other. But we not have a time to do that. We lock our humanity heart to bring heart for peace. Loving kindness and compassion is universal truth. The truth of universe is loving kindness and compassion. Okay? So I died 5.5 days and I go wrong place in the kingdom of heaven. You know how beautiful there, how strange there. But I say no, that's still control under desire. I want to come to a better place. There is no tear, no suffering. With our food, you hungry, you feel pain, right? With our water, you thirsty, you cannot survive. You cannot breathe in, that means everything is gone. But the universal teaching, there is the hospital. We go there in paradise. What we do there? We heal our three poisons: desire, hatred, and ignorance. When you know have that kind of three poison, and you bankrupt your ego, we suffer because of I, my, am, that belong to me. This planet is our human planet. My home, my school, my father, my and I, we never end up suffering. So brother, sister, today, Bhikkhu come to here, yet a little, I say this way, we are very lucky. She introduced about me during Vietnam War, when I'm 9 years old. And if I not show you my injury, you will laugh and say, how can you be suffer when you're 9, 4 years in hospital? Then sit time operation, but you're too strong. Yes, the body like the vehicle. Some car this day, the Antis car, 1926, I just meet in it like that. But the driver very good. So the car weak, but the driver strong. With the rule and regulation, we give way, we know how to control speed, we can reach whatever we want. But you got the Mercedes-Benz, Rolls Royce, or sport car, but the driver wrong in, wrong of desire, wrong because we anger, hatred, and we capture by middle ignorance. So, can collision, you see here, okay? Body. You see the finger, foot on, lock the finger. See. After send me to the hospital, they tap the towel of my father. Hundred of form, hundred of my God come out. Each one eat each other, fighting for my meat. Like the human did they, we fighting for the name, the power, them, that, you see that? So, you think they suffer? No, very limited. Only 4 years, lie down one side, this side. If you see inside here, part here, and you believe how. And I hope all of you can share the book, not only your family, but all our brothers and sisters around the world. We love each other. We born with no religion. I'm not come here to teach more religion in this planet. Too many religion. So in the website there, they have one song, He Not God. When I in India, I ordination, that means I share the hair of 7,450 young and old people become a monk like me. But normally, outside they look at the monk, but inside their mind is still monkey. Like jump and jump and jump. So we try to overcome meet the monkey. Then this year in the Chinese, they say the horse year, jump and rise and run. So we try to overcome ourselves. Then 12 million people, 3 days, they queue up 10 rows to pass by where I sit in, and they want to see me. But you know how many million? 12 million, 3 days and night. But I'm not there. I'm not this body. This body is fallen man, yet installment of earth, water, air, and heat. Not my body. My body is loving kindness. My body is peace. Like our Yesu. You know, Jesus Christ 2,000 years ago, what he sent 12 disciples for mission. He said, not allowed to touch money. They have food. You see, because money, it makes your mind greedy. You turn yourself a monkey. And that makes you see many monks. You look them look like the monk like me, but inside the monkey meet the money. And our Catholic priest, I grew up from Catholic family. The Catholic priest have to follow the 10.9. Jesus say, you have to use your human leather suit. Here barefoot, we have to be bare. Not only barefoot, but bare head. Not only bare head, but bare heart, open the heart. You see that? For all human and being to plant the seed of the mercy, the seed of liberation. So brother sister, that's enough today. I part here, then I give you the website. On the website, you can see a few hundred video YouTube about me there. Then you enjoy all the song, and I not forget to stand for the video there. He commit the, he composed the music in some of the song they call Beggar of the Century. This day, everyone, they want to go high, right? But why Bhikkhu say, I myself beggar. Beggar, nothing wrong. Beggar, nothing wrong. When we born, we beg our mother, our father. And you come to this age, you beg your teacher to give you the food for the mind. Your father, mother, just only to give you the food for the stomach, cloth to cover your skin. But more than that, because have to give up my life and I give the food for the heart. And the road for inner skin of morality. So beggar nothing wrong. Why? Beggar not killing, not stealing, not sexual misconduct. Or I'm the monk, not sexual conduct. Not to say lie. Why I have to say lie? Because I need something more. But why I have to need something more when my rope like this? If you see anyone with a rope like this, it's the map of the world. It's the farm of Maurice. 45 countries, even His Holiness Dalai Lama, my good friend, he donated the food for me. And number of people, including Hollywood, or beggar on the road, they have a chance to meet me. I come down to touch the earth, and I come up to the top to touch the heaven kingdom there. I told my friend or my son, my student, many life pass by. I become a true bhikkhu to go arm for them to dana. And they gain the merit, they born there. If this lie, you try to do hard work, you become one more prime minister, right? How many years? 2 terms, maybe 10 years. But if you become a kingdom heaven, one day there, how long here you know? Some 800 years in this offlandness. But when I go there, I say wrong place, I want to go to the paradise. 1 second in my grandfather's homeland, here is 640 years. So 640 years is enough time for you to cultivate, to overcome your desire. So brother, sister, thank you for your listening. And we come, yet only our heart of love, nothing now. Thank you. Yeah.
Okay, so maybe you have some questions that you would like to ask Bhikkhu, so please feel free to ask. Can they ask you anything about the war and about your childhood? Is that all right?
Yes.
Yes, can. Okay. So anyone like to know? Anyone inquisitive about something about Bhikkhu? Because I'm still learning about his life too, and I haven't finished reading his extraordinary story. But he's an Australian citizen now. Morgan.
What is my name?
58.
Born in the passport, my 1954, next month is my birthday, but in the Chinese, they call I'm the born the monkey year. So around 58, 59, yes.
I'm born in the monkey year, it's a monkey monk,
yeah,
but it's overcome the monkey mind. Any other questions? Come on, it's a big opportunity, yes. What inspired him to travel? What inspired you to travel, Bhikkhu?
When I stay one place in Karamata or some other country, if you come to Cambodia or come to America, Laos, Thailand, Malaysia, India, I got all the center around. But if I stitch a path to the center, I will be tied up there. So that's why our Buddha not allow us to stay one place, to travel in to meet a number of people who need us. But you see this way, when I in Karamata, I have about 300-400 followers. And every year, 300-400 followers. But when I go around the world, I can meet how many here? Yet only few hours. So that's why I wandering like a bird, not a thousand. Yesu say in the Bible, the fox have the hole, the bird have the net, the son of man not have the blade to foot the head. That's why even only 32 years old, and they massage him in the cross. You know, one day if you heard Bhikkhu Buddha Datu already put on the rod and massage, you know, free massage, free of charge, then that is the time my complete my mission. So I wandering everywhere, I meet number of people, talk with the king, love with the beggar, high education, either professor, doctor, love in some the community people, they never have a chance to know what the pen, what is the book. So I teach them. And some people, they eat too much, they enjoy too much. I say, do not born for to eat, right? Overcome your food. But you have to learn how to eat the food for the mankind, the food of the Dharma, the teaching Buddha. And the people know food, I have to share my food for them, for their stomach. So I crawl around the world to meet even the animal. The cow can bow down. The dog can understand what I'm taught. The brain and teeth can know how to respect. So thank you, your question. Anyone you want to have some doubts, please ask me.
Yes, Samia?
You looked like you had a question.
Yes.
So can I ask you a question, Bhikkhu? Could you Could you describe to Year 10 what meditation is? Or what the practice of meditation is about?
You see, many educated people, intelligent people, we gain so many high degrees. But sometimes, if we not overcome ourselves, our mind, we can do some crazy. Many of my friends, millionaire, and I have some students, billionaire, and someone very good when they are young, same age with me, in the school, but they not overcome their desire, they can lock their mind. So why we meditation? You see the body, we use too much our energy. We need to sit down. That's why nighttime, whatever you do, you must need to rest. So when we cross our leg, we sit comfortable and we ask ourselves where we come from. After we left this world, where we go, who we are. And more, we can continue to prepare now with mindfulness. You know everything, but you don't know after end of your breath. You cannot breathe in. You don't know where you go. So brother, sister, boy and girl, try every day. At least morning when you wake up, you spend about 15 minutes overcome your mind. Sit in and ask yourself what you do today. And when you go home, after school or do your homework, the same thing. Sit down before you sleep, ask yourself, 24 hours, have you do something again to humanity, again to the human law? We come to the world very easy, but after you left the world, you don't know where you go. That's not easy. Why? Buddha say, all human on this earth here, after we die, the one who born back to human dream again, that means to become a human again, like the dust in the nail, compared to the dust in the planet. That's why you see the mosquito more than human, the fish in the sea more than human, and the many kind, the bird, many kind animal. So try to climb up, more up, by overcome your desire. Desire lead you in wrong path, wrong view, wrong understanding. So when I sit meditation, I breathe in, I know what the value of that. Money cannot exchange. Big home, big car, so many degrees cannot exchange. And I breathe out, I know how I breathe out. I breathe in, and now I'm still alive. I breathe out, death, life, death. So I know the world. Everything is very impermanent. Very impermanent. That's why you heard they say VIB. VIB not mean very important person. No. VIB mean very impermanent person. Right? Very impermanent person. So before we put this body, or they put our body to the coffin, to the cemetery, or to where? To the cremation. We have to know how to put our desire, to use our mother earth to bury that, and turn ourselves non-attachment, non-self like the earth. Okay? Thank you. So that learn to be meditation. Any doubts, any question you never asked 3 million lives before, today, by her, I meet all of you, please ask me. Okay? And when I answer for you, I learn from that too.
Any more questions? I have one. Bhikkhu, how, after being so cruelly treated in the war by the enemy, how can you forgive and not be bitter and want revenge? How can you get to a state where you can have such an open heart instead of always being sad and looking back with resentment on your life?
If not the Buddha teaching, attack revenge. After I left the hospital, I come home, and I might, you know, the like the gun, but not the gun, like some of the children, they play like this way. And I see the airplane pass by, and I try to shoot airplane down, because I want the pilot have to be died to ask to fight for me. And when I see the rope of any for army or police, or I heard some of the war, very hatred into me. But the teaching of Buddha, it really for me to wake up, to walk up, to understanding. My part like karma. I occupy another country. I kill, I burn another village. So this life, I have to bear that. I happy to bear that. And I forgiveness. Forgive them, I forgive me. More than that, I thank for this injury. Did the war warm up in my body. Better than someone they do a statue. Statue, you know, in their body. But this is the war warm up. Everywhere I go, I told them, end of the war in your desire, your inner war. The civil war and outer war will end. Do not worry World War I, World War II. Do not worry about the civil war. But we worry our inner war, desire, end of the desire. Kill not the body of the Osama bin Laden or Saddam Hussein, but kill their desire, benefit of many. But kill other body is just only slaughter of four limbs, nothing of that. That's what I say. Do not need my body in Bhikkhu Buddha Dhatu four limbs here, 1.74 meter high, no. But with my body of the universal, loving, compassionate. Okay? Clear? Do not kill, do not hit everyone. Yet try to hit ourselves, punishment ourselves, and kill our desire, our hatred, our ignorance. Export ignorance out, the light enlightenment will be within you.
Thank you. So Bhikkhu, you're saying that when we feel revengeful and resentful, we're actually not only sending that energy out to someone else, but we're also damaging ourselves in doing that. So we're doubly punishing ourselves. Thank you. Are there any more questions? More comments? What time? How much time have we got? We've got 12 minutes. I've got time for one more question. Bhikkhu, just on a lighter side, anyone else got a hand up out there? Okay. Any teachers want to ask a question? Okay. Bhikkhu, how did you get to become an Australian citizen? How did you get to come to Australia?
When I'm 31 years, then I'm very handsome that time when I'm Vietnam. Not like now, it's nearly 60. And what going on then, my uncle, he a communist, he have very high rent. And for sure they kill a lot of people because they hold a gun, they live by that, and they brainwashed by the communists, and we sometimes we become the victim of the capitalist too. Because we born with no capitalist, no communist, we born with no Catholic, no Buddhist, no Baha'i, no Hindu, no. We born only middle version. Our mind very virgin, very clean and natural. So one day, I give teaching for them, spelling how in Vietnamese, and I learned that they no education, but they say too much lie to me. So I say to them, no, what I know in South Vietnam, very rich, not like what they say. And my uncle communist, he heard that, he witnessed, he come to my father, he say, no, your son cannot live in here. Your son have to go to capitalist to live, because they have a right to speech. Right, free speech is right of universal protection. But here, if he continue like that, one day they kill my nephew. So my father asked me to send my sister out of the country. And my sister and her family are now in Germany. They do very well. They done so much good after country for the country. And my mother, she born in Adelaide. My dad, the godmother, godfather, born in London. Both of them to sponsor for me to come to Victoria, to Melbourne. I here very early. That time you're not born yet. But I say this way, I'm this planet. Long ago, that means my body, your body is same. Your body is earth, my body is earth. Right? You breathe in with the air, I breathe in with the air. The universe is belong to earth, not only Australia. Because the 200 over here, when Captain Cook not to look in, to search in this island, they all see. This is yet only for the land, the earth, no self. So brother, sister, I be here with all of you, and you be in my heart of love. Okay, thank you.
So that's very interesting that even after the you weren't a refugee from the war, you were actually a refugee after the communists took over, and because you were speaking too freely in that communist regime, and then you had to be, then you became a refugee because you spoke too openly. Amazing. Well, we're very glad to have you here, Bhikkhu, and we're very honoured to have you at the Iga High School and have you as an Australian citizen. So I think Dizzy's going to come and make a special vote of thanks to you. Thank you.
On behalf of Bega High School, I'd like to thank you for coming here and talk to us. And yeah, thank you very much.
Heart for Peace website, it is. Bhikkhu's travelling around in a little combi van. It's got Heart for Peace on the side, so you might see it.
I have the mobile temple.
It's called a mobile temple.
Every child is born with virgin minds. Their hearts so pure and free from war and foolish pride. Tortured world pollutes the purest minds of innocence with ignorance.
You see another fish grab the big fish.
Another big fish cut
big
this.
Fish, look here.
I see. I understand. So this one, you try to pull the hook here, and this one eat this one, and another one eat this one too.
There's a difference, right?
I see. Two hands for him, huh? Very painful.
But it doesn't matter. He's dead already.
Yeah, but...
Because look at this. He's been eaten up. He's been eaten up, you see?
I bless him for him.
Yeah, bless him. Let him go to heaven.
Yes. No, no. He come back to human dream, but he not become an animal, no?
No.
Okay. You take this use and the man, Sangha. Forgive this man, he a good guy. He get some of the food and he put the hook inside.
Yes.
But you think he is so kind. But the human play like that, so just forgive about him. He a good man, okay? And you see man. That? Yeah.
I cut the piece off. See?
Yeah. He delete
and
one.
Then another piece.
Yeah, okay.
And you know what I do with this? I feed that to the pelicans.
Pelican, yes.
There's a pelican with one wing.
Yeah.
He can't fly.
Okay.
I've been feeding for 8 years.
Oh.
So can't fly, the pelican.
You feed the pelican and you get the fish, you know?
I
see here, you lost something here.
Look here.
See here? The hook there and the fish and many hands you try to fight for the food, you see that?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Another prayer.
Yes, another prayer.
poison tongue.
If you to Buddha, Dhamma and Sangha, you talk with me, you go back to the sea. How lucky you are.
The blind leading the blind.
See how he lucky? You happy now? Good.
Is there
he's so happy he go on. Going on. Good.
In a sacred world of poison tongue.
Good. Thank you.
Why? Why? Sacred world from poison.